So today we're speedrunning through Duck Life hard mode, and it doesn't seem like there's too much different just yet, but don't worry, there will be. This is a mod for Duck Life made by another YouTuber, Trippy Pepper, who's been doing some Duck Life stuff recently, so I thought I'd check it out. Now the story of this game is the same as usual. You have a huge farm, you're making tons of money, a tornado destroys it, and you decide the best way to make money would be racing your duck, which... Now we're gonna start the timer as soon as we press next right here, and the first thing we're gonna wanna do is start training flying. So you might be asking, how is this hard mode? Well, because of these pellets. If you hit any single one of these pellets, it will kill you. But the good thing for us, this is an EazySpeezy video. I'm just gonna cheese the entire game, so you can just start flying down here. Yeah, this is what I'm doing. So the pellets never spawn down here, so what I can do is start spam clicking down here so you go here right away, and none of the pellets even have a chance of hitting you. So while this part would usually be pretty difficult, it's more of just, you know, repeat yourself. Hey, it's a speedrun. Okay, I'm gonna use every advantage I can. Now for this level, we can get it up all the way to 150, which is what we're going to be doing. For the other ones, you can get them up even more. Because along with hard mode making the training harder, it also made it so that training has a lot more grinding. The flying section is pretty much the same, but once we get to swimming and running, you'll see where it changes. But I don't really have anything else to say, so I guess here's a time lapse. The funny thing about the flying section is while it intended to make this thing a lot harder, it made it just a lot easier. It almost did what it needed to do, but there we go. We got it right there. And now we can train running, which, yeah, this is running. So for the first little bit of running, you can't really do anything because as soon as you click to press start, you're gonna jump right away and you always hit the first boulder. So for like the first little bit of this, we just kind of have this happening to us. There's nothing we can do about it. But then we get out of that limbo and we can actually do some running training. So finally. Now you'll see the difference about running. It doesn't have the pellets trying to kill you, but the boulders are gonna come a lot faster. I mean, you already saw that by just the beginning when we kept just dying over and over again. But once you get out of that limbo, you know, we can actually have a little bit of fun. This isn't as bad anymore. But don't worry, there are more limbos for us to get into eventually. But we're gonna worry about those when we get to them. You can see, as we go on, this level is gonna get increasingly hard just because you can make the jumps, but there's no way to tell when the next boulder is gonna come. And I'm kinda just hoping. I'm hoping that there's enough spacing between these boulders to where it won't kill me. And you know, that doesn't always happen. So a lot of this run does come out to RNG. Okay, I have a really good run for this one so far. We've been doing well. I just have to keep focusing up. And by focusing up, I mean pressing the button over and over again and hoping it works. Oh, we're back in limbo. My favorite part about Duck Life, dying to the same boulder over and over again. Yeah, for the running section, I feel like there might have been a slightly better way of making this harder. I think when it works, it's really good. But then in sections like this, it just kind of ruins it. Yeah, I'm kind of, this is my life right now. You know, I kind of feel bad for my poor duck. He's trying his best and he can't do anything, but we're almost over it. Yes, we get to play the game again. But yeah, running out of all the trainings definitely isn't my favorite, but I guess it also wasn't my favorite when I was playing the original Duck Life, so it didn't change too much. But you can see that our level is now above 150. Usually in Duck Life 1, 150 is the maximum you can get to. Also, once you get up to this speed, you're kind of just hoping you get good RNG. There's not too much we can do about this, to be honest. Like, I can't even tell if those are two boulders or three, or if it's just like you're seeing the image at the same time because it's going so fast. This is so hard to tell at this point. But we are so close to being done with this. I just have to keep paying attention, making sure I don't stop too late. We have one more of these and we should be good. That is 300, and now we can train swimming. So swimming, not too much has changed about it, but besides for the fact that things kind of just randomly appear. That's where most of the hardness comes from. So what I like to do is stay near the front of the screen because then sometimes things will just spawn behind you and you can usually mostly deal with the things that come in front of you. The buoys that are on the ocean are the hardest things to deal with because especially when you're going fast, it won't let you jump or dive down. And the reason behind that is because they put you on top of them. So technically you're not in the water, so you can't do any actions. And yeah, it kind of is very annoying. So I just hope that those don't happen to me too much. We can deal with everything else except for those buoys, and those buoys kind of ruin my run and also my sanity. But you know, we're still pretty sane. What am I doing? I'm going through it at this point. Come on, man. I'm just gonna stay all the way in the front. It's spawning way too many things in front of me. I almost dived down that. Okay, we're getting fairly lucky. No, stop going in between it. It's like the duck is kissing it or something. So yeah, I'd say for the swimming section, this is definitely a good way of adding difficulty. It's not completely hard to where you can't react to it, but it definitely makes the game a bit harder. So for my ranking of the trainings, I definitely like flying the best, and then swimming, and then running, because I think that's a pretty good order of what is best to what is worse. Oh, how did we actually survive that one? Okay, can I please stop getting this bad RNG? Yes, just spawn behind me. I really appreciate that. Oh, come on, dude, duck. Duck, I need you to stop. Like, there's nothing we can do at those points. I just have to get him to around 280. There is a little bit of luck involved with that. If you want to be completely certain that you're going to win the race, you just go to 300. But I am trying to speedrun. I am trying to go fast. So I'm going to end it a little bit early and just hope it works out and doesn't lose me time in the long run. Okay, we should be finished up after this one. 279. It might be a little bit risky, but it's time to go on to the races. And no, the risky parts do not start yet. As you can see, we kind of just destroy. I forgot to get more energy. I'm an idiot. Okay, well, we're just gonna ignore that part. You might have saw with the energy, it just increases your level all the way up. I just completely forgot to do that. And we lost our, I guess it's better to come out now than come out later. But you can see these ducks, they're kind of still struggling. I mean, to be fair, we are like maximum level. It's expecting a little bit much for the amateur races to be that good, but they're still doing pretty well. Like, they are going fast. Also, why is this not ended yet? All the ducks have finished the race. Okay, thank you for wasting that extra time for me for so whatever. Okay, what do we have next? Yeah, come on, get, like, at least they're finishing the races. I can give them that. I mean, it's not a competition, but were we really expecting it to be a competition? Probably not, and we probably also shouldn't. But this should be the last one of the amateur races, and then it'll get a little more intense. I'm trying to keep it suspenseful, okay? I'm trying to keep it like, oh, maybe they can come back, but I'll just be honest, they can't. Look at our duck. Look how beautifully and far he flies. What are the other ducks supposed to do at this point? And I believe one of these ducks, yeah, the orange duck, he might be able to, oh wow, they all might be able to finish. That is actually pretty, okay, only the orange duck did. But it was still pretty impressive. And now we're on to the second world. Now we're in the city, and yeah, we have this banister climb. The ducks are a little bit better now. You can see they're going a little bit faster, but still our yellow duck doesn't really have too much competition. The next one is going to be Leap the Faith. And because we can only get up to 150 flying, some of these other ducks are pretty good at flying. I mean, not just yet, but you can see they're going pretty fast compared to us. It's not like complete decimation. It's just almost there. But speaking of complete decimation, we have that where I just jumped on the water twice. Is my duck Jesus? What just happened there? Okay, whatever. I'm just not going to worry about it. Last one of the amateur races. You combine all of them together. We're probably going to jump on the water again, which I don't know how my duck is able to do that. Maybe he won't. Let's see. I'm actually pretty curious about this. Okay, this time he didn't jump on the water. I'm not sure how he was able to do it the first time. We're making it through. It's a kind of tight race. Like, you can see there's a lot of effort going in between the other people. They just don't really have a chance at winning anyway, but a very solid effort. Pink guy, he's probably gonna finish. These guys might finish too. Yeah, good for them. I'm happy for them, especially because it saves me time of having to wait. Now we're on the third world, and we started up with Up the Volcano, and you can see now the ducks, they're pretty are, okay, no, they're not even that good yet, but they're faster than they were before. It's not a complete waste of time for me. And for this one, this is where the flying of the other ducks actually comes into being shown. Like this orange duck, he is so close to beating me. Kind of barely beat him right there, which, you know, that was a little too close for comfort, but we're not gonna worry about that. Now we have this where, again, we're jumping on the water. Look, duck, why are you doing this? How does that even work? What are the physics going on with that? And the last race of the expert races, of course, is going to be the one where we combined all of them. And I think for this one as well, we should be pretty good. I mean, we have that running speed, which really nobody can match. That's the point at which we kind of just get way ahead. Our swimming's also really good, but I think running is the point to where like the other ducks just don't have a chance when they're facing off against that. And this orange duck is really trying. But finally, it is time for the world championship and the point at which I might have messed up. We'll see if my swimming is going to be enough for this. It's a fairly tight race right now, but that's where we get ahead. I don't really know how that works or what happened with the physics, but we get ahead. This white duck is trying to catch up to us, but he's just looking at our trails behind us. He can't really do anything about it. We're pretty matched on flying, but I'm still a little bit better. And then we get to the swimming section. He's kind of catching up to me. Please actually hurry up, little duck. Okay, we made it. And that is going to be time 20:30. Wow, we were so close to the sub 20 minute and we just missed it. Oh, why does this always happen to me?